Someone's cursing my lord. Late night lunch. Someone's puffling my lord. Late night lunch. Someone's growing my lord. Late night lunch. Oh lord, late night lunch.
This is a post-Watershed production.
Hello and welcome to a late night lodge watched by a thousand eyes. Here they be dragons. We be not phantasms, but manifestations of a deranged mind grinding the gears of hell. I am your short-tempered eccentric Aaron Bliss, and next to me sits your mouthy exhibitionist, my lodge.
Hello everyone.
Woo, yay. This particular late night lodge theme will be on reality television.
Oh, just while we're on the subject of nudity and streaming it, yeah, and stuff, just thought I'd mention that the thing in the papers over the last week about the, well, online sites like using.
Oh, you mean the article
people.
I showed you just now?
Yeah. Well, I heard it on the radio earlier, and I thought, I think maybe we've all been.
We've all been guilty of what, sharing pictures that we shouldn't have.
Oh no. I collect.
Let me just make this clear, mate. When we read articles about young people are inadvertently sharing their saucy, intimate, partially and fully naked pictures on the internet,
which I fully endorse.
What we're talking about is young females.
Yes.
I don't think anyone's really going to. I don't think there's going to be a huge market. There is a market, I'm sure, but not a huge market for guys with their cocks out. Otherwise, chat roulette would be the most popular site on the planet.
Yeah, it's guys that are pervs.
Of course.
Predominantly.
They always have been. Cinema verite. People don't want contrived porn anymore. They want realistic porn. They want porn where, you know, people are consenting to. They want real people looking sensual and there.
Nah.
I'm getting a bit far. No, but, you know, the point stands. Reality. People prefer reality to contrived filmmaking, really.
Oh yeah,
porn's pretty laughable. I mean,
amateur porn's getting bigger.
Amateur porn being a thing.
Obviously it looks more real because it is.
Yeah, people don't want to see what a director imagines.
Rather than fake, like crappy, like where they try and put a storyline in and then.
Well, exactly, because it laughs at itself, and I can't understand how you could watch anything so laughable and be turned on by it.
We've just gone into talking about porn.
That's part of reality.
What? Lots of things are part of reality. Yeah, we had to go into porn.
Spectrum. Well, sex is a huge part of the human psyche, really. I mean, what?
You're telling me.
What do humans desire other than sex, food, sleep?
Food, sleep, beer, sex.
Very good, Mike.
Football. Football, beer, food, sleep, sex.
Maybe you should write up a new Bill of Rights. Bill of human entitlements. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm going to go out nutting everyone if they try and deprive me of beer, food, sleep, sex.
Well, we laugh, but you might be onto something there, Mike.
Well, that's what she said. I don't know why she said that, but whatever.
No, I think you just mugged yourself after a puffin.
I'll mug you off in a minute. Don't be a puffin. Listen to Late Night Large.
We're talking about reality television, Mike. Are you a fan?
No. It's fucking awful.
Why'd you say that?
Okay, when Big Brother first started, I watched the first couple of seasons of that, and it was cringy, but you know, I watched it. It was, you know, whatever, something to watch. It wasn't that bad. It's got so much worse. And then there's all these other reality things, and it's awful. Having said that, I'm a celebrity. I can tolerate. I can watch.
Any reason why you prefer that?
I like Ant and Dec.
You puff, man.
Other than that, I generally find it quite hard to watch. I get embarrassed for them, and sometimes if I'm not getting embarrassed for them and cringing, I'm like the state of some people on there. Just what are they alive for? And no, it's true. It's true. They, you know. Yeah, if I'm not cringing for them because they're just an absolute embarrassment, then I'm getting angry with them because they're so stupid, and you know I don't want them to speak anymore. Having said that, I've been watching the Valleys.
Oh Jesus Christ!
The Valleys.
I think those MTV reality shows have reached a new nadir. I think.
Yeah, there's just too many of them around generally, and yeah, generally they're all awful.
Are you telling me that you got a phone call? The television company saying,
"I'd be comedy gold. I'd go."
I was going to say we've heard that you're a bit of an eccentric chap. Do you fancy going on this reality television show? What would you say?
Yes.
Okay.
Now.
All right.
Pick me up.
So you'd agree?
Definitely.
And then when you get there, you find out it's like a battle royale to the death.
Even better. Kick some ass as well.
Pits of... Oh, nice. Okay.
Good.
Fair enough.
I'd love it.
Okay.
I'd go on. I'd do it. Straight away.
Interesting.
And I'd tell everyone there exactly what I thought of them as well.
Oh, would you now?
Yeah. And I'd probably have sex with a few of them as well.
The ones that you threatened.
They normally put a couple of ditzy good-looking birds on there, don't they? Like, they're stupid, but they're cute. So people like them because they're cute, but they're really
very
stupid.
And Mike,
they
yeah.
do.
Chauvinistic. It's not misogynistic.
I'm both.
Brilliant. Okay.
But no, yeah. So yeah, I'd go on there definitely away. Wouldn't even think twice.
For a brief history of reality television, and it's not a glittering history by any means, but the first kind of accepted reality television show was perceived to be Candid Camera. In 1948, so obviously you know makes sense. It's after the Second World War, so yeah, Candid Camera. I mean, you remember what that was about? That was running really recently, I think, running for donkey's years, which was just a hidden camera capturing members of the public in farcical situations and how they reacted, etc., etc. Then, of course, reality television exploded at the end of the millennium. I think it was 1999-2000 when Big Brother and Survivor in the US first piloted. Although viewing figures have generally tailed off pretty much every year, we still have a saturation of awful reality shows. Mike, reality shows come in a number of different formats. We must remember that, because we can't just think of
shouldn't generalize.
Yeah, it's not just a bunch of wannabes.
Although it is generally, but
preening about. No, because there's documentary style, which is also referred to things like Fly on the Wall or docu-drama. It's a cinema verite style, i.e. you're filming what's actually unfolding rather than scripting or directing the people involved in any way. And again, this is split up into various different segments. There's special living environment.
Tell me what.
Oh, in fact,
special living environment.
That is like Big Brother, basically. I thought it was something different, but Big Brother, Temptation Island, whatever you want to call it.
Temptation Island, I watched a bit of that. Yeah. Oh, what's his face was on it.
What's his face?
Yeah, what's his chops?
You couldn't be more vague. You're so vague.
Couple of people. Oh, what was the guy's name?
Oh, dear.
No.
I'm sure you'll remember at some point.
Yeah, I can't remember his name. It'll come back to me.
What was he doing?
What do you mean, what was he doing? He was being on a reality show, you penis.
I thought you were going to come up with an interesting story, not just, oh yeah, he's on a reality show.
No, I was just trying to remember the old boy's name. There's a couple of them.
I'm sure you'll think of it in a minute.
Why can't I remember their name? That's really annoying me. Tip of my tongue. I'll blurt it out at some point.
Celebrities.
Callum Best.
Oh, that was him, was it?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And
I bet.
Paul.
Playboy.
What's his face?
You lost me there.
But yeah, Callum Best.
Okay, celebrities.
And what's her face?
What? Kim Kardashian?
No, you knob. Tits. Ginger.
Ginger?
Yeah.
I don't know, the one out of Girls Aloud?
No, this is way before then.
Oh, sorry.
This is like, when was that? The 2001 Temptation Island.
The ginger one, what?
Well, don't worry about it. I'm just thinking of people that were on it. That's fine. You carry on. Carry on what you were going.
So the celebrity version would be, for instance, obviously the biggest or the earliest of those, the Osbournes.
Gaz's daughter. Bianca Gascoigne?
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, she was in there as well.
Yeah.
And it's been followed by things like Gene Simmons' Family Jewels, Anna Nicole Show, before she croaked, obviously, Nearly Wed's Nick and Jessica, Hogan Knows Best, all kinds of other American pap, really. Although, more interesting when, like, Tommy Lee goes to college. And obviously, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, like Mike said, one of his personal favourites.
Considering I hate reality TV, yeah, that's a big, big thing to have something like
now,
that.
Now, I've got to admit, Mike, the next kind of subcategory is the one that I probably would watch the most, or do watch the most, even though I don't really have a television. But these are the kind of things that I would flick over and probably end up slobbing to, which is professional activities. That's where you're following around, like emergency crews, the police.
I watched one today.
Go on.
I watched a couple of shows with Dog the Bounty Hunter today. I love a bit of dog.
Oh my god.
American Chopper I've seen before. Deadliest Catch.
What about Bad Cops?
No, I tend not to watch the ones about, like, when you follow, like, a paramedic round or something.
Really? Even though they'd probably be the most interesting.
No.
In fact, my dad's been watching...
I'd rather watch Dog.
That says a lot, to be honest. My dad's been watching recently, I think, Australian Border Security. Don't know if you've ever seen that.
No.
Because obviously Aussies are known for having a pretty... running a very tight
Bondi Beach
ship.
Thing as well. I watched that.
Okay.
That was good.
But yeah, the Border Patrol, they're known for running a tight ship as regards immigration. In other words, they don't take any shit from anyone. So you get some interesting scenarios. You know, like, isn't the British version like airport? But I mean, that's a bit
airline thing.
Isn't it airport? Because it's it's people at the actual airport, not the...
That's cool.
Anyway,
it doesn't matter. It's cool.
That British thing. That's really airy fairy and weak compared to like Australian Border Security, which has some much more interesting cases, especially with like tropical creatures. Very cool. Other than the professional activities, which I'm most likely to watch, what have we got? People with disabilities. So that's usually people who are pretty extraordinary. I think there was a show about dwarves. Yeah, seven dwarves.
The Undateables. Oh.
Now that's pretty cruel. This is Mike. What do you think about these kind of shows?
I just need to, if anyone hasn't seen it, try and find it on like whatever on the internet somewhere. Like. Watch some of the Undateables. It's good.
Really? Are you a guest on the show?
What do you think?
I bet you're the presenter.
Call me Casanova.
Oh, I know another reality show that I did watch.
Grow on.
Lad It to Lady. You remember that?
Oh, mate.
It was quite amusing.
We are giving it the big un.
As always. Living at large on Late Night Large.
Oh, yeah.
The subcategory we've just stumbled upon now, Ethnic American. Basically, it's not ethnic American, it's ethnic. And it's happening at my Big Fat Gypsy Wedding. What is it? Jewish Mother of the Year that they're doing at the moment.
Yeah, some crap like that.
Yeah, and in America they've got Lebanese American, Shia Muslim families, and all kinds of other stuff to give people an insight into how these people operate. Although, again, we should be aware that editing does have a great ability to shape people's perceptions. Thus, you can exaggerate and cut out good parts and exaggerate bad parts to...
Or vice versa.
Shape people's impressions of whoever's on the show. Okay, another big section is the competition game show format, which is still reality, obviously, because even though it's a contrived environment, you're not scripting people exactly what to do. They're taking part in competition and... what have you. Mike, you still have the Krypton Factor.
Yes. What I don't like is that stupid them dancing ones.
Yeah, that reminds
awful.
It's competition game shows. That would probably apply to the number one brain anaesthetic of the current population, who have having all their rights stripped away while they just talk about what's on X Factor. And Pop Idol, American Idol, all kinds of...
Deal or New Deal does my bloody head
in. It's all the same dirge, really, isn't it?
Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? I used to like that.
Yeah, for a period I did. To be honest, they don't really make great game shows anymore.
No.
Once or twice, good ones pop up. The Chase isn't too bad. And other versions of competitions are things like also The Biggest Loser, which is like obviously a weight loss competition. It gives producers exactly what they want, which is a hard luck story or a rags to riches story or a triumph of human spirit and endeavour
whatever.
Dating-based competitions. This is your kind of thing, Mike. I'll take this...
No competition if I'm involved, mate.
Oh, yeah, right, okay. So it used to be, I'd imagine, you know, when it was, we were in slightly more innocent times, and it was like Cilla Black with, what was it called? Blind Date.
Blind Date, yeah.
And now it's slightly more lewd and,
shit.
Your shit with, like, Take Me Out and things like that.
Oh, no, I love Take Me Out.
Yeah, I bet you do. It's also things like The Bachelor, Farmer Wants a Wife, things like that. Go on then, explain to me why Take Me Out is good. Why it's worth
Paddy McGuinness.
My time. He's a prat.
No, he's not.
No, I know why you like him. Oh, he's a lad, yeah, he's like one of us.
Yeah, he's Collie.
Okay, well, we'll agree to disagree with that. Job search? What the?
What's that?
Ah, I'd imagine that's something a little bit like, yeah, The Celebrity Apprentice, The Apprentice, Dragon's Den.
So that Dragon's kind of Den's alright.
Yeah, I mean, other than the smug, superior attitude of the lucky bastards who are actually dragons, who, you know, think that they're like, they hold the keys to the world.
If they're lucky, they probably worked really hard to be where they are.
I'm sure it took a great deal of luck as well.
Of course it did.
Business is luck.
Yeah,
look at, you just got to look at things like, I'm just giving an obvious example.
You can't say they didn't earn it.
Everyone, there's an argument that everyone earns any success that they get, but then there's an argument that people don't. I'm sure they're great. So, job search. We got sports. That's things like The Ultimate Fighter, The Contender. I swear they had that one where the prize was an amateur contract or a professional contract at Chelsea or something. They had that years and years ago. The prize was a youth... maybe not a professional, youth contract at Chelsea.
Oh, yeah.
I think they had that, so that would be an example of that.
Don't know how I didn't win that.
No. No, I mean, I kind of understand how you didn't win it either. Like, you didn't even show up, you were so confident.
Yeah, but they should have just given it to me, but whatever.
Yeah.
Obviously, I'd have immediately requested a transfer.
Obviously, yeah. Once you've got your foot in the door, you've been demanding a transfer to United.
That's it.
Self-improvement or makeover shows. That's, I imagine, like, home makeover and also personal makeover. Gok won crap. Trini and Susanna. The Biggest Loser again.
Queer eye for a straight guy.
What not to wear. Oh. Absolutely vacuous, most of these.
Awful shit.
Renovation. Again, that's classic.
Slightly better, Pimp My Ride.
Woo! Extreme Makeover, Home Edition, Pimp My Ride, obviously.
Pimp My Ride, yeah. The rest is crap. Ramsay's Kitchen
Nightmares. Ramsay's Kitchen Nightmares is put into the renovation bracket because of the fact that they try and turn around businesses.
It's good because he swears a lot.
I used to actually be quite avid watcher of Ramsay's Kitchen Nightmares or whatever the other ones were, Kitchens from Hell and whatever it was.
Hell's Kitchen.
Not so much cook competitions, more like, yeah, Ramsay's Kitchen Nightmares, where he actually turned around a restaurant.
Yeah.
Because then you actually got the full picture where, you know, who was to blame? It wasn't just the chefs or the waiters and waitresses. Sometimes it was the manager, sometimes it was the owner, and then sometimes, like you say, it was the waiters and waitresses were spitting in the customer's food. So I really like that. Social experiment. This is an example. Things like Wife Swap, Secret Millionaire, where people go into uncomfortable social situations, see if the human spirit bonds.
See what's growing on.
Binds them, or see what's growing on. Oh, wow. There was a controversial 2004 UK series where contestants competed for how long they could go without sleep. Wow. I'm not surprised that sleep deprivation was a...
It's a form of torture.
Well, it is a form of torture, but it's also a fantastic hallucinogenic experiment. It would be very interesting to just film someone relentlessly, see how they reacted to that. I've heard you can...
pay me enough money.
I've heard you can write fantastic poetry and probably even paint really well when you're in that kind of lucid state between waking and being asleep. Hidden cameras, again, this stems from Candid Camera. Obviously, Candid Camera was, you know, like, basically an unusual situation that someone stumbled into, seeing their reaction. Then it moved on to slightly more nasty territory, where it was people actually having pranks played on them. Thinking of Beatles about, Jeremy Beadle was king of them for a while. And then we had like Punk'd, Trigger Happy TV, etc., etc., etc. Supernatural and paranormal. I struggle to call these reality shows.
It's just
These are, to be honest,
some of the most awful crap you will ever witness.
Personal opinion. Again, my personal opinion is not gospel. Personal opinion.
No, but mine is.
Most of these people are con artists.
It's just ridiculous.
It's very much making huge deals out of very trivial incidents. Preachers are converted, basically. Oh, was that a spirit I just felt? And everyone at home who desperately believes in spirits kind of says, yeah, it was. And for everyone else, there's nothing remotely that could be classified as evidence to attest to any of it. So, yeah,
so it's crap.
It's chicanery, most of it. Hoaxes. Again, Jeremy Beadle used to do these on his show, didn't he?
Yeah.
Like the classic space landing episode, did you see that? Where they pretended to have an alien land in a woman's garden.
I don't know.
She was really, really tripped out by it. It's quite good. There's a lot of versions of hoaxes. And again, that plays into like the candid camera model as well, etc., etc. So, that hasn't gone into any of the categories, what about bum fights? Things like bum fights, what you might call exploitative reality shows. Do you know what I mean?
No.
Filming desperate people and saying paying them to do pretty degrading things or...
Yeah, but...
But I tell you what, bum fights, the one thing it did do is get some great characters. That crack smoking guy. I can't remember what his name was. He was an absolute legend.
Aaron Bliss?
Those days are behind me, Mike.
If you say so.
Hey, yeah, yeah. Hey, yeah, yeah. I said hey. What's growing on? Carry on, Mike, please.
No, you don't deserve it.
Welcome back.
Not at one point did we talk about Total Wipeout.
Are
you not familiar with Total Wipeout?
I said grow on.
Total Wipeout's quality. For those of you who somehow wouldn't or aren't familiar, it's just a game show where contestants have to go and get through like an obstacle course. And it's funny because they just get wiped out, and a lot of them are pretty stupid. And yeah, it's good. Shows like that. I can't believe you've never.
People have said that it is a political and especially sociological phenomenon. Reality television telling us a lot about ourselves. Do you agree with that?
No. It tells us a lot about the idiots that you see.
Really?
Not all of them are idiots, obviously, but
although Mike,
95% of them.
Okay. Well, maybe in this country, but. As it mentions, in some authoritarian countries, reality television voting has been the first time many of the citizens have actually voted in any free and fair wide-scale elections, which is pretty incredible.
Yeah, I guess.
I mean,
it doesn't really impact us.
Yeah, well, it's pretty pathetic that in our country people tend to view the vote of an X Factor wannabe to be more important than the national vote. But then I guess that's where we've come. That's what she said. They discussed the concept of having reality shows as substitutes for scripted drama. Now, Mike, I could be very cynical about this. I've noticed that MTV seems to have basically stopped a lot of its diverse and original output the last 5 years or so, and it's just more and more vacuous reality television shows. Do you agree with that?
I do agree. I couldn't agree more.
I mean, they used to have really kind of edgy cartoons. You know, the Beavis and Butthead, Daria, Downtown, these kind of things.
They do still have that.
Really?
Yeah.
Or do they just repeat the old classics?
I suppose. But a lot of the new stuff is just, like you say, shit.
Far be it from us to be, like I say, the voice of complete reason. It's only our own personal opinion.
No, but of course my opinion counts for more than anyone else's. So.
Yeah, of course, far far more valid by virtue of the fact that you're a radio DJ and celebrity
Yes.
in your own lunchtime. So,
Thanks.
There's a union critique of reality television where, you know, unions basically say that people who appear in these aren't union represented, thus, you know, there's significant decrease in expenditure for producers and broadcasters, thus the cynicism increases. It's a cheap option, isn't it?
Indeedy.
And it does have a weird hypnotising effect to people that just, they're just agog at... Mike, what do you think about the concept of people loving reality shows because they see people that they pity and think of as being beneath them, which makes them feel better about themselves?
Pretty sad state of affairs. I think a lot of the people that like these reality TV shows, to be honest, like them because the people, the morons that they see on there, actually they relate to. That's probably more the case. It just says something about our society these days, doesn't it? I mean,
it says here, social cognitive theory suggests that meaningful sources of identity can be discovered by people in their teens who feel connected to what they're viewing.
There you go.
Thus, when attempting to understand media's role in the development of teenagers, it is crucial to be aware of the time they devote to their shows like reality television due to this strong influence.
It turns people into twats.
Well, yeah, because you watch these people and they're kind of attention-seeking saddos, really, aren't they? Yeah. Most of them. And do people really want to emulate these people?
Obviously.
But why? Do you think it's literally because of the law of, oh, they're on television, so they must be worthy?
Yes, and people are stupid. They are, these days, sorry. But, like, fully formed and educated and, well, decent people like you and I can look at these people on TV and think, look at the state of them. I really hope I never have the misfortune of meeting anyone. Well, we all know people like that. Meeting these people.
Yeah.
And just cringe at them and see them for what they are. Whereas obviously there's some misguided youths that actually take something out of what they see. Shame.
Okay, Mike, you know when I said how strange and sad it is that people would want to emulate these attention-seeking saddos?
Yeah, they clearly would want to emulate
because,
me.
Could it be... I was going to say, surely they'd want to emulate people who were worth emulating, like superstar radio DJs and MCs like us.
Yeah, Mike Large especially. Cheers.
Right, Mike. I was going to say, it might not be because they necessarily admire these people, but they see the 15 minutes of fame that... you know, follows on with all the money and glittering star appearances that comes with that.
Yeah, it's just stupid.
For 5 or 10 minutes, I mean, anyway.
What's wrong with when people used to want to emulate football players or racing drivers or people that are actually worth, you know, firemen, oh, hero, wicked, nice,
okay,
one,
but
or whatever. Or David Beckham.
Yeah, well, those are all quite talented people and it takes quite a lot of talent and dedication, whereas
exactly, surely it's,
yeah,
it's better.
No,
than
I agree.
Want to emulate,
I agree what you're saying,
people.
But don't you? If you're a teenager and you see someone on TV and say you've got low self-esteem and you think, oh, you know, people call me bitchy and people call me overweight and whatever, and you see someone on TV who looks worse than you,
who's a fat bitchy slag,
who's more bitchy than you or whatever, and you suddenly accept your flaws, and the problem is, accepting your flaws is one thing. That's probably a good thing.
But then you stop seeing them as flaws.
Yeah, that's the problem, isn't it? You start seeing those flaws as your ticket to stardom, and you don't realise that the reason these people become stars is because people are basically mocking them.
Yeah, they put them on TV to be laughed at.
They are kind of pretty shameful characters. People sort of, they make them famous and they laugh behind their backs. If you're prepared to trade away your dignity, pride, whatever you want to call it, for, you know, the promise of potentially some filthy lucre, then by all means, that's the right career path to choose, although it's fraught with danger and you're pretty unemployable if it doesn't work, if I'm being honest.
Couldn't agree more.
Thanks, Mike.
It's all right. Every now and again we share a common opinion.
What do you think about something like Jackass? That is technically a reality show.
Oh, it's funny as fuck.
Although it is scripted, but scripted on the hoof, I'd imagine, with the kind of pranks that they pull on themselves.
Yeah, that's funny. That's people acting like morons. Like, they're not actually astute. Like, they do a lot of stupid things, and they probably are not completely normal, but they do... They act more stupid than they actually are. Like, Johnny Knoxville is actually quite an intelligent bloke, but he doesn't act like one. It's for comedy. It's funny. Well, and like you say, they're scripted. It's acting.
True. It kind of blurs the boundaries, doesn't it? Because it is clearly scripted, but at the same time, these ridiculous pranks are obviously thought up by the people taking part in them.
Oh, it's bloody stupid things to do, but it's entertaining to see. It's funny. You know, it's not something you don't have to take seriously.
We shouldn't forget that reality television, like most other forms of entertainment, should hopefully be escapism more than anything else. The problem is, like you say, if you're talking about escapism as watching dull non-entities be very dull and just idiots, that's not really the kind of escapism that helps you become someone better, does it? Like, for instance, people use escapism to either get away from the drudgery of your own existence, or it helps you dream of how to, you know, reach that better existence eventually, if you get what I mean. It's either one of those. Now, the thing with reality television, you know what they say, when you dream, you should always look up. You should always think, oh, you know, what if I was in this situation? Now, there's an argument that reality television convinces you to look down. Oh, look how stupid those people are.
Yeah.
And they're rich and famous. I can do it too.
I could make myself look like a twat as well.
Yeah. Whereas surely you should be looking in the other direction. Like, oh, I might not be that good, but maybe I could get close. I could chase it one day.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
I'd like to apologise for leaving this on a positive note.
Yeah.
I don't know what I was thinking.
Bloody idiot.
So there's not much left to say except thank you for listening, tolerating another Late Night Large.